guys, my name is JessiMew, and welcome back to Shelter 2. In the last episode, our cubs successfully grew up. They are fully grown adults now, though unfortunately we did lose one in the wintertime to a huge pack of wolves that completely ambushed us in the middle of the night, I believe it was. So unfortunately, again, we only have 3 fully grown cubs, just like last time, just like in our first playthrough. But that's okay. We're glad to have any, to be honest. We made it all the way over to that snowflake symbol too. That's currently where we are in the snowflake territory. I don't know what you would call this. And there's a lot of bunnies here, but there's also some deer somewhere around here too. We saw them off in the distance when it was winter time. So hopefully they're still here, and hopefully our cubs can now help us take down some of those deer. That would be amazing to see if we could all go after that herd of deer and maybe take some down for ourselves. But for now, we probably should keep going after these bunnies to make sure that our big cubs are fed, because I know last time we found that these guys really require a lot more food than they did when they were little, which makes sense because they're big now, so they need more to sustain themselves. And they can hunt for themselves. I know sometimes we would find that they would kind of go after their own food, and sometimes they would bring it back to their mother too, which was absolutely adorable. But so far, they're kind of letting their mother catch all their meals right now. So we're going to have to keep smelling and looking out for these little tiny morsels waiting for us in the bushes. Hopefully those wolves won't be coming after us anytime soon. Why did the cats just meowed for some reason? I get nervous when I hear those weird noises. And oh my gosh, did Ember just go to catch something? Did you go to catch something, little guy? Oh, those are the eggs again. Okay. Look at how big these guys are though. That is amazing. Actually, Ember seems to have a darker coat than Galaxy, which is kind of neat. So they are a little bit different from each other. I thought they were basically exactly the same because they do have the same markings and whatnot, but she's just, or he rather, is just a little bit bigger or darker than Galaxy. Oh my gosh, I'm messing up my words today, guys. I don't have words today. But we should go after one of these bunnies, I think. Maybe this one, because this one doesn't look like it sees us just yet. Well, it might. Oh, really? Run straight into the jaws of your predator? Really? Really, little bunny? Well, that one was just asking for it, honestly. I'm kind of still keeping an eye out for those deer, though, because I was really hoping that we could find the deer again and see if we could catch them. I believe they were out this way somewhere. I'm gonna try to get this guy. There we go. They're just running toward me now. This is bizarre. Oh my gosh, Luna, you caught a little ground mole. I love that. I absolutely love that when they catch their own food. That is so cute. It goes to show that we're really helping them learn how to survive on their own. We're really helping them out by teaching them how to hunt right now. So we're doing a pretty good job being a mother to this trio of cubs, and that's so good to see. They're going to have a good time surviving on their own once it's time for them to take the path of solitude, just like our first group of cubs. It's getting dark again, guys. Uh-oh. Last time it was getting this dark, the wolves were coming. Oh, the wolves are coming again. I hear them. Run! Run. Run, little cubs. Do not look back. Just run. Run away from the wolves. Oh my gosh. No, where are they coming from? Okay, where are they coming from, guys? Where are they coming from? That is the first question. Where are they coming from? I don't see them yet. Oh, but I hear them. They are coming. Did they get one of them? No. Oh, there they are. Oh my gosh, they're huge. They're huge. Oh, no. You get away from my cubs. Oh my gosh, did they take one already? Did they take one? Did they take two? What's going on? No, they took one. Oh my gosh, guys, they took rain. The wolves took rain. Oh my gosh, I really don't know how to get away from those. Maybe we should have jumped up here. We should have jumped on the platform, you guys. Oh my gosh, I didn't even think of that. We could have jumped up here and avoided them. Oh my gosh, no. They took rain. Now we only have 2 cubs. Oh gosh, this is worrying. I hope we're going to be able to make it through the rest of the season. This is really worrying, guys. Well, I see the deer up there, and that's what we wanted to begin with, but I'm so sad now we only have two. Oh my gosh, and I see... Is that an owl in the tree? Right by the sun, that's an owl. Oh my gosh, can we catch the owl? Wouldn't that be strange? Can we, like, actually climb that tree? That would be really strange. Hopefully my cubs are gonna follow me. You guys, you kind of need to come down now. It's like they don't really understand how to jump down. Come on, guys, come on. You can just jump, just like that. You're big cubs now. You did better when you were, like, little tiny babies. Where'd you go? There you are. They teleported, but that's okay. I'm glad that they teleported rather than staying trapped up on top of that little mountain, or a cliff rather. I'm not sure what you call that. It's not really a hill. It's not a mountain. It's just like a little slab of land. But I want to try to climb this tree before we go after the deer, because I'm curious to see if we can get up here. Oh my gosh, we can. Mouse left. It looks like we can kind of like knock this stuff down, maybe. Oh my gosh, she's shaking the tree. That is so cute. And now we have a nice pile of eggs to eat too. Hopefully the owl's not going to get like really mad at us. Come down and start pecking us or something. That wouldn't be good. But I think we're good. Now our two lone cubs have been fed. And we can go out this way and try to find those deer again. Did I just hear something crack? Did I just hear a twig crack? Usually that means that something is following us, but I don't really see anything right. Oh my gosh, Luna, you scared the heck out of me. I thought she was that fox. Goodness, Luna, don't you do what? What? Okay. Oh my gosh, these cubs, they're like literally terrifying me, but they're just getting me food, I guess. So I guess that's good. Thank you guys. Or you guys can eat it too. I'm so confused right now. It has been such a chaotic day. We have a group of deer over this way, and we also have some right behind us. So which one should we go for, guys? I mean, we did go this way before, and that's when the wolves came out. So I don't know if this is the best one to go after. I'm not sure. It makes me really nervous. Like, I'm really not sure how we can even get away from the wolves because there are so many of them. There are so many wolves in a single pack that it kind of makes me think that we could not win a fight. Even though my cubs are bigger now and they would probably help us fight the wolves, I feel like we just couldn't win that. I'm not sure if we just have to keep running away from them or maybe if we just scare them off. I have a feeling that we probably had to escape by jumping on that slab of land, whatever you would call it. That's probably what we had to do. Jump right up on that shelf. So if it happens again, guys, that's what we're going to look for. We're going to look for those shelves to jump on, and hopefully the wolves can't follow us up there. I have a feeling they're probably not as good jumpers as our lynxes are, so I think that would probably be our best bet if we run into the wolves again. There are quite a few of those shelves around here. I'm going to call them shelves now, apparently. Those are shelves. But where'd the deer go? The deer were out here, right? I see little tiny red specks, but I think those are little bunnies, yeah. Did the deer disappear? That's kind of upsetting. We made it all the way out here, guys, and now you're gone. I scattered the bunnies, and now I can't find them. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. And my cubs weren't very successful either, unfortunately. So they couldn't bring anything to their mother to eat. But that's okay. We can still continue on and try to find where those deer went. I'm really not sure. Oh, wait a second. Is that them in the distance? I think I see those little antlers poking up. I think those are the deer. Okay. So if I remember correctly from our last playthrough, we have to kind of jump on these guys to take them down properly. And I feel like they're going to see us because we're coming straight at them, aren't we? This is just like the fox situation when the fox was coming after us and it was coming straight at us. Like, I'm staring this fox down and he's walking straight at me. Like, I don't see you, fox. They're probably thinking the same thing about us right now. Like, all right, there's this family of lynxes just walking straight toward us. I think their backs are turned to us at this moment, though. And my cubs, like, don't run at them, guys. We need to coordinate here. We need to coordinate our efforts so we can take down these deer properly. But my cubs are getting so far away from me. This is really a bit nerve-wracking. Yeah, there we go. We have to jump on those big, majestic deer to take them down properly. But I have to kind of surprise them, too. So let's see. Let's see if we can get this guy. It's a very big meal, so it's got to be harder to catch. Oh, but I got it. Harder to catch. Yeah, sure. Sure, guys. We'll let them eat that. I'm not sure if I can get a little bit out of it too. I mean, I know it's a really big meal, but maybe it would be a good idea just to let them eat it anyway. Because we know that it'll feed them really, really well for the seasons to come. So we'll let them eat that, and then we'll collect the skull. Little deer skull. We don't have many of those either. I don't know if we collected it in the last playthrough or not. And I think we might be reaching the end of this territory. It's kind of hard to tell, but it looks like there's a lot of water in the distance, so it might be the end of the snowflake territory, or the wolf territory, rather. Or wait a second, is it? It's all, like, blue in the distance, so it looks like water, but... Oh gosh, that scares me so much when my cubs actually catch food, and I hear that, like, that big, that big sound. It sounds like someone's getting taken. Was that Ember who caught that? I guess Ember just caught a nice rabbit for, his sister, actually. Luna the Second was able to gobble that up before, her mother could grab a little bite, so... They're all watching out for each other, which I think is really adorable about this game. Let's try to get this bunny in front of us. Are we gonna be able to outrun it? Maybe? There we go! We got it, guys! I feel like maybe I should eat this. Yeah, I'll eat this one, guys. You guys catch your own bunnies, okay? I know you guys can! I know you can catch your bunnies! Maybe Luna will catch one for Ember. That would be kind of cute. Catching food for each other is like very good siblings, like the good siblings they are. And let's see, is there anything else out here? It seems kind of bare out here, so I'm not sure if this is going to help us too much. There's not many bunnies out in the distance. It really seems like we might be reaching like the boundaries of the snowflake territory. And again, I'm a little bit concerned that we might be running straight toward that pack of wolves again. We know that they're out and about. There's sound again. That sound. Ember! Wow! You are really good at catching food, huh? Catching it for your sister again. Are you bringing it to your sister or to your mom, maybe? I'll eat this one, guys. I'll eat it again. Why not? I wish, I'm sure they would probably eat if they were really, really hungry. And what's that in the distance? Is that something? Okay, those might just be flowers. Yeah, those are just flowers. I thought those were like a bunch of bunnies popping up, but that's not the case. It looks like we have a little bit of food over this way though, so we're going to hurry this way so we can catch this bunny. Oh, it's like one lone bunny out here. That's a little bit worrying. We really have to catch this one then. We really have to catch this one. We can't let it get away from us. It's kind of slow actually, so it's not too bad, but both of our cubs can eat this. So they'll be able to keep going as we continue along this path. Now I'm a little bit worried that we might not actually be able to make it back to our den because we did have to cross the frozen ice to even get to this area. And now that winter is done, I'm not really sure what's going on here? Uh-oh. What is going on here? What is going on, guys? Oh, this is spooky. What on earth? Everything just went like inverse for a while. What on earth was that? Did we just eat like mushrooms or something? Oh my gosh. That was terrifying. I'm not sure if like our Lynx was gonna pass out or something if I stayed in there, but we're not gonna go back in that big field of grass. We're gonna go this way. I think we'll try to go back toward the den actually. We'll go toward the- Oh gosh, that scares me every time! Every time I jump! That time it was Luna though. Luna catching something for her brother! Oh, that is so cute! Oh, she's eating it too. She's like, wait a second, I'm a little bit hungry, so I'm actually going to eat that. That's a bit awkward, guys. I'm sure you could eat a little bit less awkwardly than that. But let's go this way. We'll go toward the big tree again, which is where our den is. And we'll hope that we can actually get back to that area. It won't be blocked off by the river because it's no longer frozen over, I'd imagine. Actually, I wonder if we're getting into the summertime. Do you think we are? Every time, guys! That scares me every single time. But they are really doing well hunting. We must have taught them really, really well because they're even better than our first group of cubs were. I know every now and then our first group of cubs would catch frogs and stuff, but this time, like, every couple steps, they seem to be catching another bunny, so they are certainly doing well for themselves. And even though we only have two surviving cubs now, I have a feeling that they're going to do very well on their own anyway, because they've been taught so well. And we've had a lot of trials, too. We've certainly had a lot of trials with these awful, awful wolves roaming around this area. Can I catch this bunny? There we go. I don't want to be like the one person in the family who can't catch rabbits. But we've been doing pretty good for ourselves, so we'll let them eat that. And I think we'll collect the bunny skull too, because we are, of course, avid skull collectors in this game. In autumn, when the hills are yellow and red, the cubs are called to follow the path of solitude. So there we go, guys. I guess pretty soon the cubs are going to be leaving to enjoy their lives on their own. And I know last time we had to make it all the way back to our den before we could properly end out our Mother Lynx's journey. So hopefully we can make it to the den, guys. Hopefully. And hopefully our cubs will follow us all the way there. I don't really want to leave them off in wolf country here, because I feel like that would just be a really awful place to live. I know we've caught a lot of food here. There are a lot of bunnies in wolf country, but there are also awful packs of wolves that like to ambush you at every corner. So we're going to try to make it back toward the forest that we began in, and hopefully we'll be able to settle back into our den before the autumn time rolls around. How much further are we, guys? It looks like it's like just over the hill there. I don't really want to run out of stamina either, just in case the wolves do decide to ambush us again. But it seems like we should be transitioning any time now back into that forest where our den usually is. So let's see. Hopefully we'll be able to get back to our den, guys. I'm a little bit worried about that. Oh, the deer again. Should we get a deer? They are right here, guys. We might as well. Oh, what is that sound? Oh, they give me that awful meow and I think that something's wrong. But I guess they're okay. So let's see if we can get this. Let's just run because I think they see us. Oh no, 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 no. They're getting way too far away, guys. Oh, ooh, ooh. I have a bunny in my mouth though. Oh man. I think we were stopped because we had the bunny in our mouths. Aw. But they are still up there. There's a chance that I could run into those guys again because we are going this way anyway. Toward the big tree where our home is. So let's keep going this way and see what we can find. They may have actually disappeared out here. It's kind of hard to tell. I just see bunnies. Well, maybe my cubs will grab one. That would be nice. I was really hoping that they would help us hunt the deer, but so far they haven't, which is okay. It's okay, guys. I know it's kind of a big job, but I was hoping that you guys would do it anyway. This place is really huge. I didn't realize that it was so big. I didn't realize that we went so far out. It takes a while to get all the way back to this big tree. But there's so many bunnies in the way too. There's the deer again. Okay guys, let's try this one more time. We'll try to get these deer one more time. Hopefully my cubs aren't going to scare them off. They're like darting in and out of all this tall grass here. I think Luna sees them. I think Luna is very interested in this herd of deer. Let's see. Hopefully we'll be able to catch it. Hopefully. Oh, Luna, you scared them. You have to get down and stalk them. You don't just run straight up to them, right? All right. Well, let's go this way. Oh. Oh, no. It's the fall time, guys. Autumn has come. Does that mean that my cubs are going to leave me? Oh my gosh. I love the way it looks here though. Everything is so vibrant. So much more so than when we were in our forest. I wonder if they're going to leave me here, if we have to go all the way back to our den first. That's a good question. And again, hopefully we can cross the river here. Oh. Oh, I know what this means, guys. They've stopped. This means that Ember and Luna the second are ready to go on their own journey now. Oh my gosh, guys. Well, goodbye. Goodbye yet again. I'm really sorry to leave you in wolf country. I hope you guys have a good life, though. I know we've taught you well. We've taught you very well. We've taught you how to hunt. We've taught you how not to scare deer, hopefully. But I guess our mother, Lynx, is going to have to make it back to her den all by herself. And we're going to hope that the wolves don't come out and try to pick her off in the meantime, because that would not be good, would it? So let's go back home. Oh, it feels so desolate without our cubs, though. It's so sad. I have no little cubs running after me. It's just our mother Lynx now, as we make our way home. There we go. I finally see our big tree in the distance. That is our home. That is where our den is. That is where we began this game twice now. That's where our mother Lynx always has her cubs. This is our home, and I believe this is the opening to the den. So let's let Galaxy go back to her den so she can rest after spending so much time teaching her cubs how to hunt and how to survive and how to run away from wolves, which unfortunately didn't work out so well. Unfortunately, both Leaf and Rain were taken from us by that wolf pack. So only Ember and Luna II were able to survive this playthrough, but we're glad that we were able to see them off, and hopefully they'll have a good time in Wolf Country. Hopefully they'll move away from Wolf Country, actually. I would rather see them not live with all those wolf packs, because that's probably not the best place for them to be able to survive. But now, of course, just like Ina, Galaxy is going to return to the stars herself so she can help her cubs by guiding them along as one of these beautiful stars littering the meadow here. And I believe we can follow them along, just like before, we follow them along to our destiny. And I believe I had figured that our previous mother Lynx was most likely taken down by those awful wolves once we reach the end here, because of course the stars are leading us on. They're showing us that it's our time. It's our time to return to the stars ourselves so we can lead our current cubs on and help them have cubs of their own. This is actually the end of our Shelter 2 Let's Play, but I do have Paws all ready to go. Paws is the next game in the Shelter 2 series itself. And I believe you play as a baby Lynx and a baby bear. I'm not entirely sure, but I am really looking forward to it. So I hope you guys are looking as forward to it as I am. And if you are, then feel free to subscribe to the channel and you'll see that video popping up on your homepage on Friday. I'll be posting shelter videos, of course, every Friday as usual. And here we are, guys. We are at the Meadow of the Fireflies. All of these little lights in the distance. I'm not sure, maybe they're stars. Maybe they're actually the stars of all of our ancestors. Because this is where we go, where we're going to become one of the stars ourselves. At least that's what I believe. I think that's what this is trying to represent, that we're going to help our cubs along by guiding them as one of the stars too. So once we get close enough, we should be able to see our ancestors playing in the stars, and we'll be able to become one ourselves. So let's see. It's so beautiful, though. There they are. Oh, look at them. That one kind of looks like our friend Atlas from the last playthrough. Look at that. Or maybe Leaf. Maybe that's Leaf coming with us. Hello, little Leaf. I'm sorry that we weren't able to save you, but it looks like you grew big and strong anyway, and I'm very happy to see that. So let's run. Let's go, guys. Run through the fireflies as fast as we can. Oh, gosh. I love this ending. It's so much better than Shelter 2, where we just got picked up by an awful bird. So we can run through the fireflies, run with our cub. So that's it for now, guys, but thank you all so much for watching today, and I will see you all next time. Bye!